Hello students, welcome to my YouTube channel. So today we'll be discussing about institutional representation of democracy. So this is the chapter 2 of the part civics. So you can open your books and you can go through it. So today we'll be discussing about the representation of democracy. Who is the representatives? So first of all, let's see the points what we'll be discussing today. So in number one, we'll be discussing about Universal Adult Franchise, UAF. In number two, we'll be discussing about significance of UAF, Universal Adult Franchise. In number three, we'll be discussing about election. Number four, types of voting. Number five, types of election. Number six, election procedure. Number seven, political parties. Number eight, types of party system. Number nine, function of political parties. Number 10, ruling parties. Number 11, role of ruling parties. Number 12, opposition party. And number 13, coalition government. And we will be looking after the names of political parties and their symbols at the last. So let's begin today's class explanation, and I request all the students to open your books and please go through the videos and try to understand it. So first we'll be discussing, that is first point, that is Universal Adult Franchise. So Universal Adult Franchise, what is the definition of Universal Adult Franchise? Universal Adult Franchise is given to all Indian citizens who have attained the age of 18 years. Any citizens of the country who attains the age of 18 years, they get one right to vote at the age of 18. So when you will be at the age of 18, you will get the voter ID card and you will be able to vote your representatives. So these rights, who gives us? The parliament, constitution of our country under the article 325 and 326. So you have to remember this point, article 325 and 326, the citizens get equal rights to vote. It doesn't mean you belongs to which caste, you belongs to which religion, it doesn't mean. You get equal rights, male or female. Who cannot vote? Those who are mentally not stable, that means mentally not fit, they are unable to vote. And number two is that whoever convicted as a criminal by the honorable court, they cannot vote. So these two types of people, they cannot vote and they don't get rights to vote. Now let's come to see the significance of UAF, Universal Adult Franchise. What is that? It provides equal rights to all citizens of the country. Okay, number one, that is, provides, UAF provides equal rights to all citizens of the country. Here the point is missing. It's supposed to be A, B, C, but please correct it, and in your notes you'll get the correct notes. So you follow the notes after the video. So it provides equal rights to all the citizens of the country. It protects citizens' rights and liberty. Whatever citizens' rights is there and liberty is there, Universal Adult Franchise protects it. Number three, that is to protect citizens' interests through their representatives. Whomever we select, our leader, we select through this franchise, or universal adult franchise that gives us right to vote and select our own leaders. Number four, it imparts political education. Not only it gives us rights, but it also gives the political education. How to vote, to whom to vote. We can decide, we can take our own decision. It strengthens national unity. So it unites us, whatever may be the people, what may be the religion, what may be the caste, creed, race or sect. All it unites through our votes, voting rights. It gives the citizens self-respect, self-pride and self-confidence. Either you are rich or either you are poor, male, female, maybe you have different religion. It gives us, voting rights gives us self-respect, self-pride and self-confidence. And it also gives non-violence revolt. We can fight or we can select the good leaders through the voting. We no need to fight, we no need to go violent. Next, number three, that election. So first of all, we'll discuss about election. So election plays very important role in our democratic country. So number eight point is that election plays a significant role in the formation of modern representative democratic government. Through election only we can elect our government. So it plays very important role in democratic country like India. Number B, the Election Commission of India is responsible for conducting free and fair elections in India. So who can conduct election? Only the Election Commission or Election Commissioner of India can conduct free and fair election. It may be by ballot paper or EVM machine. Again, it says that the Election Commission of India consists of Chief Election Commissioner and two Election Commissioner. So Election Commission consists of, means it contains one Chief Election Commissioner and two other Election Commissioners. Number 4 points is that types of voting. So we can say there are two types of voting, direct voting and indirect voting. In direct voting, what we can do, the voters, they select their own representatives by direct voting. An example is that MP vote. Member of parliament, when we select directly. And number two is that indirect voting. Indirect voting, we elect our representative, in indirect vote, representatives, whomever we elect as MPs, they select the other representatives like president of our country. President of a country is elected indirectly. So these are two differences between direct voting and indirect voting. So in number five, we get the types of election. So types of election. So we have got three types of election. First one is general election, and that is conducted after 5 years, after the completion of 5 years. And number two is midterm election, before expiry of 5 years. If suppose the government could not last for more than 2 or 3 years, or maybe 1 year, or it cannot continue till 5 years, then emergency occurs and midday election is conducted. And another one is by-election. By-election is if suppose any representative or any MP dies, or the seat of the MP is vacant, then the election occurs. The election is conducted, and that is known as by-election. And one example we can give, I can give, in our locality, recently one MP died from Rangapara, and there should be a held election for that seat, but unfortunately coronavirus came and there is no election. So that is by election. That type of election is known as by election. Number six is that election procedure. So what are the election procedures? Before election, there is a fixation of election. Number one is fixation of election constitutions. And this, the fixation of election constitution comes under Delimitation Commission Act of 1952. So according to area, according to population, constitutions are fixed, and that come under the Act of 1952. Number B is that preparation of electoral roll. It comes under Article 325. So whatever we say, it is as a voter list. In local language we say voter list. That is electoral roll. The election commission, they prepare electoral roll under the Article 325 or the ID cards, voter ID. Number three is announcement of election dates, and the commissioner, election commissioner, announces the dates when to be held. Number D is the establishment of the polling station, and it is one of the important procedure. Polling station, most of the government buildings like school institutions, colleges, it is booked for the polling booths, or it is marked as the polling stations. Number five, nomination of the candidates, and it is one of the important procedure. The nomination of candidates, it is very important for the election to be a candidate. And all the parties, it may be BJP, Congress and other parties, regional parties, they nominate their own candidates according to their qualifications, according to the work. Number D is scrutiny and withdrawal of nomination paper. Some dates are given, according to that they are verified, and if suppose someone wants to withdraw from their nomination, they can withdraw it within that time. Next one is election campaign. So we have heard this about election campaign. Very big campaign used to be held before the election. Some of them used to serve in local language, Hathor Sinod Bhor Diyo. This type of campaign is held all over the country during the election, before the election, sorry. Next one is polling. Polling means all the citizens, those who are having the age 18 years and above, they go with the proof of ID and go and vote for their candidates, their representatives. And next number is that counting of votes. After the polling, there is a counting of votes. In this counting of votes, many candidates, nominated candidates, they select the other candidates to go for counting the votes. Then last one is declaration of results. After the counting ends, there is a declaration of results. So whoever gets the more votes, that candidate wins, and the party whoever gets majority votes, that party makes the government. So these are the procedures of elections. Number seven is that political parties. Political parties. So first of all, let's see the definition of political parties. So according to the I have taken two famous persons quotation. Before that, I would like to say the definitions, proper definition of a political party is that a political party is an organized group of people with same common ideology for securing power or contesting elections. So political party means a organized group of people who have got same ideology for securing power and contesting election. So two definition I have taken for the political parties. First one is Gilchrist. According to Gilchrist, an organized group of people who prefer to share the same political views and who, by acting as a political unit, try to control the government. So they have got the common goal, common view to rule the government, according to Gilchrist. According to Gestalt, a political party consists of a group of citizens more or less organized who act as a political unit and who, by the use of their voting power, aim to control the government and carry out their general policies. So whatever policies are there. So both the this one definition a little bit similar. A group of people who consist of same ideology. They have got same voting aim, voting power aim, and aim of controlling the government and carry out the general policies, whatever policies they have after forming the government. So from these two definitions, we can understand that I have taken out few important points from there. From these two definitions, that first point is that an organized group of people to be a political party, to form a political party, we need an organized group of people. Number two is that similarity by political ideology. We should have same ideology. Number C is that common aim. We should have common aim. If you have get different aims, then there we cannot say that political party will last for a long time. Number D is that peaceful means of attaining political power, not violence way. It is peaceful way or non-violence way to get the political party power. And that is the only way is that voting. By voting we can, or the party can get the political power, peaceful way. Number 8 is the types of party system. So in the world we have got different types of political party system. So first of all we have to understand the party system. What is the definition of party system? The complex interrelationship between and among parties is crucial in structuring the way political system work. This network or relationship is called a political system. So it is very important to know the party system. So it is says that according to definition that it is very complex. It is out of understanding. But we can understand it if you are a politician. Without that, we can understand. So there are three types of party system. One party system, that is only one party rules the country. And that exists in China and Cuba. In China and Cuba, only one party system is there. There is no election for them. Number B, bi-party system, means two-party system. And examples are England and America, USA. They consist of two-party system. Only two-party system, two-party they can play the election. And number C is the multi-party system, more than two. It may be three, four, five, and anyhow. That is multi-party system. And India is one of the best example of multi-party system. In India, we have got more than two parties. Then France and Israel, these are the countries who conduct, who have multi-party system. So number nine, let's see, number nine point is that functions of political party, and it is one of the important things about political party system. Functions, what are the functions of political party? They have to contest for elections. Number A, they have to contest and they have to win. Number B is the form and run the government. After winning the election, after forming, getting the majority vote, they have to form and run the government and rule the country. Number C is the provide link between the people and the government, and they have to provide link between the people in the government. If they don't provide it, they become Hitlers. Number D, provide political education and awareness among the people. They have to provide political education and awareness among the people. Number five, or number E, form public opinion. They have to take the public opinion. They have to form it. They cannot become the Hitlers. Then next point is the ruling party. What is ruling party? Let's see the definition. In a democratic parliament system, the party elected by the majority in the parliament is called the ruling or the governing by exercising their voting rights. Ruling party means any party who gets the majority vote, they becomes the ruling party. So what is the role of a ruling party? Number 11, role of a ruling party. Number A, formation of union cabinet, the planning commission and the cabinet committee under the supervision of head of the ruling party. So whoever may be the head, he should form union cabinet, the planning commission and the cabinet committees, and that is the role of a party, ruling party. Number B is to serve as a link between the executive and the cabinet. They have to link between the executive and the cabinet and the people of the city country. Number C is that the head of the ruling party is a chairman of an extra constitutional advisory body, and the ruling party, whoever gets the majority vote, the head of the party becomes the chairman of the extra constitutional advisory body. Let's see the number 12 point, opposition party, and it is one of the important party system in democratic country. Opposition party. Without opposition party, the ruling party will become the Hitlers. They will become Hitlers. The powers will exist only in one party. So that is why opposition party plays an important role in democratic country like India. So India is a very vast country, and democracy playing very important role. And in the democracy, opposition party also playing very important role. And what are the role of opposition party? At present in our India, who is the opposition party? Congress and other parties, leftists. And who is the ruling party? BJP and other coalition government. And that coalition government will get in the last point. And in that coalition government, if they are united together, that is known as coalition government. And at present, NDA is the coalition government of ruling party. So next point, the role of a opposition party. What will be the role of a opposition party? Number A, check on the misuse of power by the ruling party. So the role of opposition party is only to check whether the ruling party is misusing the power or not. If they are misusing the power, they have to oppose it. That is the role. Number B, forms public opinion in their favor. They have to come and form when opposing or opposing the misuse of power. They have to gather or form public opinion in their favor. Number C, spread political power or political awareness. They have, ruling party also has got this role, the duty to spread political awareness, as well as the opposition party also has. Number D is to provide, it provides an alternative. If suppose the ruling party is not doing well, not leading the country through the development, then opposition party can provide alternatives for that. Number A, try to make government accountable towards the need of people. They also has to raise the voice of people center. Whatever people they need, they have to raise this voice to the ruling party. They have to oppose Number 13 is the coalition government, and it is one of the very important form of government. Without this, coalition government cannot be formed. In democratic country like India, one of the very big country. So let's see the terms. What is the term coalition government means? The term coalition government refers to an alliance between different political parties to form and run the government. So different political parties coming together to rule the government or to form the government, that government is known as coalition government. So below are the political parties in India, those who rule the country under the different alliance. And number one is the NDA government, or at present the NDA government exists ruling the country. And NDA means National Democratic Alliance. Next one is B, United Progressive Alliance. Here the Congress whenever forms a government with the other parties, it is known as UPA, EPA government, or United Progressive Alliance. Next one is United Front. United Front, it doesn't exist now. Only two alliance government exist, that is National Democratic Alliance and United Progressive Front. These were existed before. At present, it is not there. United Front, that existed 1996 to 1998. United Front. Then comes the National Front. Then Left Democratic Front. Democratic Front of Maharashtra. These are the coalition government which rule the country. Then next point is the parties of the country, different political parties. So let's see. Number one, Indian National Congress, or we can say INC. What is the symbol? Let's see the symbol. Here you see symbol N. This is the symbol of Congress party, or Indian National Congress. Number two, Bharatiya Janata Party. So what is the symbol? Number two is Bharatiya Janata Party. You see, you are familiar with the symbol. Number three, Communist Party of India. So in Assam, it is very rare to see the symbol. So then also symbols, you see. Number four party is that Communist Party of India, Marxist. Their ideology is Marxist, Lenin Marxist. And their symbol is little different from Communist Party of India. Number five, Bahujan Samaj Party. You see the symbol, it is unfamiliar. It is mostly popular in UP, Uttar Pradesh. Next number is Nationalist Congress Party. So it is the government. They have formed government in West Bengal, Mamata Banerjee. She is the leader of this. Number seven, Aam Aadmi Party, Jhadu. You have seen that Aam Aadmi Party, ruling party of Delhi. Arvind Kejriwal, the chief minister of this party. Then comes the Assam Gana Parishad. So it is very familiar in Assam, very famous Assam Gana Parishad. Number 9, Bodoland People's Front, Hagrama Mohilare. Number 10, All India United Democratic Front. The symbol is lock and key. It is the Azmal Badruddin. So these are the political parties of India, and this is the end of the video. So it is very important to go through the video and understand the chapter. I have given only the main points, and same the main points you'll get in PDF file and Microsoft Office file. So I will provide you in the link below. So please download it and read it at home once again. and go through the books of class 7. Please go through it. So hope all are keeping fine. Thank you.